to thank you for inviting me here for the first anniversary of the Yesterday Night Assembly. It is always a pleasure to be among you, honorable members of the House. It is even more so as you have given me another opportunity to present a State of the State address on account of my stewardship in the last year and a chance to comment on current and salient issues that affect the polity. When I took the oath of office, I pledged to serve and protect the people of Oyo State. In the past year, our actions, policies, and projects have been geared towards ensuring that the impact of good governance reaches everyone in our state. From the entrepreneurs and managers of large corporate organizations to the market woman and even the micro driver on our roads. To be fair, the first year in office for every administration is always used to plan and set things in motion. But in most cases, when the people have voted massively for ideological change, they are in a hurry to see the resolution of issues that affect them. There is pressure to hit the ground running and set the ball rolling. I can report to you that these expectations are not lost on us, which is why from the outset we built our roadmap for accelerated development in Oyo State 2019 to 2023 around four pillars: the economy, education, healthcare, and security. Permit me, therefore, to present a situation report that encompasses these key areas. Economic indices published by the Nigerian Bureau of Statistics, NBS, for April to May 2020 show that with the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic in Nigeria, 92% of households felt a substantial or moderate threats to their household finances, 92%. This figure is 18% higher than 17% of households who reported they were very or somewhat worried about them or a family member becoming seriously ill from contracting coronavirus. This 18% may seem insignificant, but 18% in a state like Oyo State, with a population of over 7 million people, we're talking about at least 1 million people. The 18% represents close to 1 million people. So I've decided to lead the report on the economy with these statistics because some persons have been worried about the Oyo State government's response to COVID-19. I have repeated every time I've had an opportunity that our response has been based on science, data, and logic. We have been careful to ensure that our response to this pandemic does not create more problems than the pandemic itself. And so, aside from effecting a partial lockdown, our administration played our part to grow the economy by consistently paying salaries and pensions for March, April, and May, even though most of the civil servants have been away from work. I want to use this opportunity to thank you, the honorable members of this hallowed chamber, for the sacrifice you made in supporting us in meeting these obligations by taking a 30% cut in your monthly allocation. Meanwhile, we have conducted over 3,500 tests in the state, placing us in the top four, highest testing states in Nigeria. And just yesterday, the Nigerian Center for Disease Control, NCDC, approved a second diagnostic laboratory for testing for COVID-19 in the state. So we now have the biorepository and clinical virology lab in the University College Hospital Ibadan. So we can even get the results faster now. Education continues to be one of the best ways to fight poverty and improve our economy. We are aware that having the right infrastructure for education is a necessity. For this reason, we completed hundreds of infrastructural projects in the last year. Yet, you will agree with me that one of the areas that suffered under the COVID-19 climate is the education sector. Schools were among the first places to be shut down and will be among the last to be reopened. We are concerned that our children are not learning. Even though we have put in place the school on air program, the reality is that a combination of factors, including inadequate power supply and not only necessary devices, another infrastructure, is affecting its effectiveness. We want our children to go back to school, but we cannot do that without mapping the transmission of the coronavirus in our communities. And this is why ramping up testing, as we're now doing, especially in communities outside Ibadan, is necessary. As soon as I leave here, I'm going to hour to commission the isolation center in there. And I understand that one of you, Honorable Seyi Adisa, has contributed his own bit towards making that a reality. So we really thank you. So far, we are testing in 10 additional local government areas across the state. We have projected a July 15 date for the resumption of schools, but that date is dependent on the risk situation analysis presently being carried out by experts. For this same reason, we have held off from reversing our directive on religious gatherings. We saw what happened when a private organization did not follow the advisories we provided to the letter. Over 50% of COVID-19 cases in Oyo State can be traced to just one organization. So I take this opportunity to again plead with our religious leaders to be patient with us. We are keeping our eyes on the numbers and will adjust this directive at the right time. On healthcare, I'm happy to report we have just started a new funding system for primary healthcare. I will be commissioning the primary healthcare facility at Afin Oyo immediately after this address as well. When I go to Oyo, also do that. So part of the 22.5 billion naira infrastructural loan that you so graciously approved, we go into developing the healthcare sector. We have set the standard we want for our primary healthcare centers. And anyone who has visited the renovated and equipped PHCs, the one at the Orion, even the one we're going to commission at the Afin Oyo, and the one I commissioned last week at the Adam Comprehensive Health Center at the Igrama Ibadan, will testify to the fact that the standard is high. So there's one thing that the COVID-19 pandemic should have taught us. It is that we have to get our house in order. Little did we know that in our lifetime, there will be any sickness that will force everyone, no matter their social status, to depend on our local healthcare facilities for any chance of survival. With the Infectious Disease Center at Ododo and more ongoing upgrades to healthcare facilities in Saki, Ogbomosho, Igbuora, we're in a better place. And even the other facilities, the facility at our, if you see it before and what we have in there now, you notice that we are in a better place, healthcare wise, than we were a year ago. Ultimately, we plan to renovate and also rehabilitate one primary healthcare center per ward in Oyo State. We know this is a daunting task, but it is one we are determined to accomplish. Let me also, at this time, update you on the 7.6 billion naira loan borrowed by the previous administration, but which you approved to be repurposed for the rural farm estates. The funds were released to us by the Central Bank of Nigeria towards the end of March 2020, and we're now set to commence the upgrading of the farm settlement starting in July 2020. The commencement was affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Again, I especially thank you for the role you played in making this a reality. And also all those that, even before we came in, that played one role or the other towards stopping that 7.6 billion from being misused, because the money was already gone. We were going to purchase tractors. And quite frankly, we looked through the documents and we found out that there's no tractor coming from anywhere. So I especially thank you for your support. I cannot end this address without giving an update on the issue of security in Oyo State. I also listened to your debate, you know, this morning, the comments on security and gender-based violence, rape. I'll comment a little bit on it shortly. But we're constituting the Amatekun Corps, which, as you are aware, will complement the efforts of the Federal Security Forces in securing our state. Within the next 1 month, they will be fully operational. I believe I wrote this letter, the right honorable speaker read. I wrote it like a week ago, but surely he got here. Maybe when we finish e-governance, we do electronic transmission, and then you can get it almost immediately. But within the next 1 month, the Amatekun Corps will be fully operational once you approve from this honorable house the chairman and the commander that we sent across. I want to also at this point commend the moves by this legislature to review the laws on rape and sexual assault. The Honorable Attorney General is here. I actually signed off on an executive bill regarding rape and sexual assault, and I'm sure you should be having that almost immediately. That's, it's just awaiting transmitter to hear. We all know that one of the best ways to address any type of crime is to strengthen the legislation around it. On our part, we will do well to enforce the laws as directed by the judiciary. So all the arms of government must continue to show zero tolerance for sexual violence. Only in this way will we honor those who have been victims of these heinous crimes and ensure that the rest of the population are protected. Once again, I want to thank you for the opportunity you have given me this day. As you celebrate the first anniversary of this solemn assembly, it is my prayer that we continue to work together for the overall good of the people of Oyo State. And I pray that the cooperation and togetherness that we have enjoyed this past year continue to abide with us until we complete our tenure. And those that are looking for a tenure elongation, they still have to go back to the people of Oyo State. So may God bless you. God bless Oyo State. Thank you.